Designing a database for an information system always starts with an analysis of the problem. We need to listen to the demands of the client, stop, and think about what they really need. Let's take an example. A small private clinic, which employs several doctors, wants to have a patient management system with all the relevant information about their patients. The questions we need to ask are, what information are we dealing with? What will the system need to do with that information? How will it be used, and how are the different elements related? In this case, we want to store basic information about the patients and the doctors. Who are they? We know that we will need to have appointments and that the system will have to include some billing system. We also know that doctors will want to be able to take notes about their patients. We can translate that into a basic schematic representation of the data structure. We have identified the main elements, patient, doctor, appointment, and notes. For each of those, we can think about their attributes. We can already tell that there is another entity hidden behind the patient and doctor, the person. The next step is to analyze the relationships between the entities. For instance, one patient can only be linked to one person and vice versa. On the other hand, one patient can be linked to many appointments, while an appointment will only concern one patient and one doctor, and a note can be linked to a specific appointment or just to one patient and one doctor. This helps us determine where the foreign keys will be in our final schema. Here, we show primary keys in bold and foreign keys in italics. Each foreign key is a reference to the primary key of another table. We could create this whole database using the command line interface, but it would not be very practical. Instead, let's use a database design program, dbeaver. First, we have to connect dbeaver to the database. It's important to understand that dbeaver and the command line are both different programs which interact with the database service, and that they do so by communicating through the port. A database connection will always require three pieces of information. Where the connection is, with the host and port, who is trying to connect, with the username and password, and what is the user trying to access, with the database. In our case, we want to connect to localhost on port 3306, with the credentials that we created in the last video, and we want to access the InfoH400 database, also from the previous video. Once we have defined the connection, we can start working on the design. Exploring the InfoH400 database, we can see the test table that we created in the previous video. Let's delete it so that we can start from scratch. We can look at the SQL command that dbeaver is going to execute. When we click on persist, the command is sent to the database. We can now start creating the tables and columns following the structure we defined earlier. For each column, we have to define the name, the type, and, if necessary, the special attributes, such as not null or auto increments. can add the primary key in the Constraints tab. When we save our changes, we can once again see the SQL commands that are about to be executed. We can now do the same for the next table. We can look at the entity relationship diagram to see what our current structure looks like. We see that there is no connection yet between our table. For that, we need to add the foreign keys. To define a foreign key from a table, we need to define the reference table, meaning which table does the key points to, and the columns in both tables that are used for the connection. In this case, it's the ID patient column in both the patient and person tables. It's possible to define automatic actions when something happens to the reference data. For instance, if we set the onDelete action to cascade, it means that if the patient is deleted, the person should be deleted as well. We could choose to instead set the value of the ID patient column to null, or simply refuse to delete the patient to make sure that we don't lose any reference. In the entity relationship diagram, we will now be able to see connection once we persist the change. We can now proceed in the same way to add all the remaining tables and references. The entity relationship diagram shows that the design corresponds to what we wanted, with all the desired connections between the tables. It's also possible to use the DBViewer interface to insert data into the tables. The data will be inserted when we save the table. Databases can also be exported to or imported from another location. That will be for next time.